And then what he does from that point, from verse 4 all the way to verse 9, is he lays out three pieces of interlocking evidence for the resurrection. He tries to make a case for us. Three pieces. The first is there's an empty tomb. In verse 4, it says that Jesus was buried in a grave after he died, and then he rose. He was in the grave, and then he wasn't in the grave. All the Gospels actually attest to the fact that there were some of his own disciples and several women who observed the exact tomb and the exact time when they laid Jesus' body into the tomb.